I could do this whole video in line for Dutch Brothers. That's crazy. Weird. Gross, disgusting, weird things. Literally, I'm just stuck in line. So you guys know, don't worry. We're not driving. I'm literally in an exit, a motorcycle lane. No, like a walk person lane, bike lane, a something lane. That's not the highway. This is how much Dutch Brothers is coveted and loved in Las Vegas. Let's talk about weird things that happened to me during pregnancy. Weird, gross, disgusting, weird things. This started because, first of all, that TikTok responding to pregnancy TikToks video I did, there was a woman who said when she was pregnant and she ate asparagus, her pee didn't stink. And I was like, girl, me too. I thought it was just me. I thought maybe something was wrong with my nose. I had no idea. And one of my friends, Melissa, works, I think, in an ER or in the NICU, something like that. And she asked one of the doctors about it. He said yes, and there was like a scientific explanation that, of course, I can't remember right now. We're gonna blame it on pregnancy brain. But that gave me the idea for this video. So number one, in honor of the TikTok lady, my friend Melissa, and my ability to eat asparagus and not clear a room when I go to a public ladies' room, is your pee doesn't stink when you eat asparagus. At least mine doesn't. Number two, most ladies, when they get pregnant, immediately from day one get really hot. They start getting hormonal hot flashes. Now, I'm sure for me that's coming in the future, but I was the exact opposite. I only heard of one other person this happened to, and it was Shawn East. She said it on her channel. She's pregnant with baby number two. She's the Olympic gymnast, who I also think I want to be best friends with. I'm like, hello, CrossFit athlete, Olympic gold medalist gymnast. We're practically twins. I want to be best friends. You're adorable. Not even close to twins. She has gold medals. I have like two trophies from Miss Fitness New Jersey. Not really the same. Anyway, so she says the exact same thing happens to her. I was the exact opposite when I got pregnant. I am cold all the time. I'm talking Adam will be in shorts and a t-shirt or no shirt. I am wearing a jacket and I'm cold usually. I don't sweat. I noticed this in the gym. I'm one of those people that I will drip buckets just during a warm-up normally. And I was telling Adam, I'm like, and he drips, you have to mop after he works out. But normally that's me. I didn't even think about it until like a couple of times in a row. I'm like, man, I did not get a good workout today. I guess I'm slacking. I guess I'm just tired because of the hormones or whatever. And then the next day I would wake up ridiculously sore. And that happened two or three times in a row. And I was like, wait a minute, I'm not sweating. I might get a teeny bit of like dampness in my sports bra in a same type of workout that I would be dripping just from the warm up. First and foremost, do you guys know what that means? My medical people, can you tell me if that's a thing? Why some people don't sweat during pregnancy? Okay, this video is gonna be so fun to edit because I'm just in a babbling mood. Number three, didn't know this was gonna happen. I heard it could happen and it did happen. TMI all the way, but this video is gonna be TMI because it's gross things that happen during pregnancy. It's gonna be gross things. Your nipples, I heard early on that they get bigger and they get darker. The scientific reason is because it's easier for the baby to find them when it's time to feed. You guys, it just happened at 25 weeks. No, 24 weeks. I'm not 25 weeks yet. I'm like 24 and a half weeks. Flying saucer areolas. They did get a little bit darker. I'm pretty pink. They're more of like a rosy, like a red at this point. They're not brown. I will let you know if they go there. The sad thing is I heard it doesn't go away afterwards. Like stretch marks will go away, but I heard that part does not go away. So mommy makeover in my near future when Adam and I are rich and famous, I'm just saying. But I mean, first we have to be discovered. Maybe it'll be from the jailbird bow video. Pregnant with the jailbird bows, baby. Hey. Okay. Next thing, and I just noticed this the other day and it just dawned on me that it was happening, is that a lot of women say that they turn into hairy gorillas when they get pregnant and they have to shave their stomachs and they get a happy trail and they have to even shave their faces sometimes. It's hormone related. For me, it's the exact opposite. Now, I'm not in my third trimester yet. I still have two more weeks to get there. So maybe it's coming, but for me, it's the opposite. I have to shave less. My hypothesis, this is just me making this up, is that I am normally a hairy beast Italian, that maybe it's the way my body's responding to the hormones and like the shock to my body is like, oh, we're not gonna grow as much hair as we normally do. So I normally have to shave like under my arms, especially the way I work out. I'm always in a tank top. I don't like working out with sleeves. It's a weird pet peeve. You guys that have been with me for a while, you know, I don't even like working out in a crew neck. I feel like I'm choking. I'm weird. I told you guys, I'm weird. I embrace my weird, but I'm weird. So the point is, usually I'll get like a 5 o'clock shadow down there. Down there, not down there. That's a whole different story. We could add this one in. You have to blind shave down there. Didn't realize that is a thing. I'm just starting to have to blind shave like this week. I could still kind of lift it a little bit. The stomach's not hard enough yet at the bottom to see. Oh Lord, this is on the internet. Is this an all-time low or is this an all-time high? Nobody tells you these things. You need to know. Here's a crazy one, you guys, a crazy one. And it doesn't just happen to me. Oh my God, this is like the TMI-est of all of them. When I first took my pregnancy test, so I was 4 weeks-ish pregnant. Within days, I noticed this awful, it's not awful, it's just weird, a skin tag right here on my areola, right next to my, above my nipple, on the areola, we'll just say there. In my head, my medical hypothesis was that it's because, I don't know if you guys know this, you don't just have your nipple that, you know, one nipple. You have nipples all around, little nipples all around the big nipple. Am I gonna get demonetized? Can you say nipple on YouTube? I don't know. I was on one of the pregnancy apps one day and this girl's like, she posted and she was like, I developed a weird skin tag since I've been pregnant on my nipple. And I was like, girl, I thought it was just me. I can't tell you how many responses I started with. Girl, me too. I thought it was just me. And a lot of people commented the same thing. Some people said they pulled them off. Ah! How? No. Ow. And I think it's a nipple. Like, I think it's, look it up. It's there. Another girl said it shriveled up and it fell off. I don't know. Mine's there. It's fine. I don't care. These get worse and worse and worse. Okay. Let me preface this one by saying, as soon as I found out I was pregnant, I called around for gynecologists. I'm new to the area. I moved here in mid-September and I got pregnant in mid-October. Less than 4 weeks after I moved here, I had no doctors. I'm not a doctor type of girl. You guys know this. So I literally just Googled and found good reviews. Nobody would take me before 8 weeks. So it was between these two doctors that both had stellar reviews. And I just went with the one that would take me earlier. I called both offices. This is a really long backstory and this is a really long video, but just FYI, that's what I did in case you're new to an area and get pregnant or honestly need new doctors. Google reviews are great. I had a pap smear. Because I hadn't been for a pap smear in a while and I'm new to this doctor. So like my first ultrasound and everything, they confirmed pregnancy. They did a whole history and a pap smear and a blood test. Negative for everything. I'm fine. That's a background story to tell you that I feel like I stink down there all the time like fish. It's disgusting. I know. I tell Adam all the time, can you smell me? And he's like, it's in your head. And one of my girlfriends is like, it is your height, and she's a nurse. She's like, it's just your heightened sense of smell with your pregnancy. She's like, honestly, I don't think you stink. But I'm telling you guys, I swear, and it always happens at the most inopportune times where I can't fix it. Well, it's discharge that smells, in my opinion, like fish. I am going to talk to my doctor about it again, but I have nothing wrong with me. It's no STD, no VD, whatever you guys want to say, because I was tested for all of that a couple months ago. Anybody else? That said, number 7, I should have flipped these, is with pregnancy comes increased discharge. Yeah, the fun stuff. So one of my friends warned me of that a long time ago and she's like, girl, you're gonna have to wear panty liners. And I'm like, oh, disgusting. It does not happen to me very frequently, but it's like you don't know when it's gonna happen, so you kind of have to always be prepared because then the DCs happen. Oh, by the way, my sisters and I call it the DCs. So I'm talking about something that you're like, huh? Discharge. The DCs happen. Much better way to say it, because who likes that DIC word? Blech. Who likes that DIC word? Family friendly, as Peter Mom would say. You know what I mean, the discharge word. Blech. It's just gross. I do not get it often, thank God, but I never got it. Like, I got it when I was younger, like first going through puberty, high school years, then really never, and now back, it's back with pregnancy. So be prepared for that and buy yourself some panty liners. I keep a little Ziploc of them. Are we gonna do this? Are we actually gonna do this? We're gonna do this. I keep a little Ziploc of them in my purse. I also actually don't have them because Target didn't, but I'm on my way there to get some stuff for Adam. Get like the good wipes where it's all natural, it's all organic ingredients, of course, because baby, well, always for me, but especially when I have baby inside of my belly, just for when it happens, like at the gym and stuff, I'll feel better about it. So there's that. Consider yourself warned. Something that I think is happening to me, but didn't quite happen all the way to me, is the black line that goes down your stomach. It's called linea nigra. I think I'm saying that right. They say for boys, it happens belly button down. It's a wives' tale. And for girls, it's usually your whole stomach. I'm starting to see it belly button down, very, very, very light, but I'm fair. And they say the more fair you are, you might have it, but you just don't see it. I'm in the car. Can't you even notice? So I'll take a picture of my belly and I'll put it up there to show you guys. When I first started seeing this, I still can wear my regular cotton leggings that don't have too much lycra in them that I always usually just wear. Always usually is a common phrase that I say that makes no sense. But I usually wear to bed. I always just thought it was the seam that was causing that. But last night it was really hot. So I just wore a very, very loose pair of cotton shorts. There was no line there. And that same exact line is still there. It's faint and it is only belly button down, which, check for wives' tales. In my wives' tales, testing wives' tales video, where Adam and I both thought we were having a girl, I'll pop the link to it up there. It's a cute video. I even peed in a cup and tested my urine with baking soda. Yes, I did. He was such a good sport and he did that video with me. We had so much fun doing it. But I mentioned linea nigra in there and he was like, hold on, what? Back up. What's that? And I was like, are you scared? And he's like, no, I'm just curious. I've never heard of that before. And I literally showed him pictures on Google. So it's starting, but mine's like, it's not even brown yet. It's just like a darker color of my complexion. The next one is you turn into a roadmap of veins. I just noticed this probably 3 or 4 days ago. I wish I was wearing a lower cut shirt. I have no problem showing you guys. You can't see in here and I don't want to go too low because I look like I'm in a drive-thru. For coffee. Because you have 40% more blood flow in your body from the day you got pregnant, you could see my arms, or maybe you can't see my arms, but I have this like bicep vein that is going strong. And for me to get that vein to show, I have to be very low body fat. But right now, I'm obviously not low body fat. I've gained at least 20 pounds, and that was 4 weeks ago. So I'm sure I've gained probably closer to 30 pounds at this point because your girl just keeps growing. My body responds to estrogen. I'm built like a fertility goddess. We'll just leave it at that. And I just gained weight from estrogen and from hormones. I still have that bicep vein. I'm so impressed with myself. I got myself back there. I had no idea what I was about to say or what I forgot to say. Okay, three more. Most innie belly buttons turn into outies. I'm like halfway there. At this point, I'm sure I'm going to turn into an outie. I thought I had a very deep belly button, but I've also had my belly button pierced for 25 years. It's really long. I took it out when I first found out I was pregnant. I'm like, meh. I thought you always had to. I've heard of people who kept theirs in the whole time. I don't love the way it looks. So I just figured it was time. I took it out. The whole point in telling you guys that is I never really got a good view for the past like 20 years, 22, 3, 4, 5, whatever it is, of the inside of my belly button. It's definitely an innie. I just thought it was deep. But right now, it's like half innie, half outie. And here's a very fun fact. Maybe not so much unknown fact about me. When you get very low in body fat because your skin on your stomach stretches, your belly button looks more like it pulls. So your belly button will push out a little bit more. Very similar reason to why when you're pregnant, because your skin is all stretched out just for a different reason. So is that mine?
You have a lemonade and a banana.
I did not.
No?
No, I had a freeze.
Okay, I got you.
Thank you. These kids are so cute. I swear, I don't know who trains the Dutch Brother employees, but they are, or Dutch Bros, I'm supposed to say, somebody told me. It's like a Vegas thing. Anyway, let's see if I can get myself back again. Yeah, so your belly button's like an innie and an outie-ish, or at least mine was. I don't know if mine's gonna pop out all the way. I kind of hope not, because I'm so used to being an innie. Outies kind of freak me out. I'm sorry if you're an outie. That's not hate or shame. It's just on my body. I wouldn't know what to do with it. Next is a lot of people say that they pee themselves for when they sneeze or when they laugh. It has not, thank God, happened to me yet. I thought it's only the third trimester, but one of my friends told me it happened to her right away and it stayed the whole entire time. The only thing I'm thinking is that I might have a stronger pelvis floor from all of the lifting and deadlifts and squats that I've done throughout the years. I don't know if that's a thing or not. I've read somewhere that that could actually weaken your pelvis floor. Oh, here's my drink, yay. Thank you so much.
No problem, have a good one.
You too. Here's the freeze. When it's sugar-free, it's called a carburetor, I forgot. just love these adorable kids. I have not peed myself yet, thank God. My sister says just keep doing your Kegels, which I think are disgusting, but I heard that, I'm like on it. And what's weird is when I do them, you guys, this is the TMI-est video of life. Do you love me for it? Tell me if you love me for it. Give me a thumbs up. Tell me in the comments, do you like when we get down and dirty? And girl, gloves off, girl talk. Let's just throw all caution to the wind. Forget the boys. We're just gonna get down and dirty. The last one is what is referred to, and I had no idea, as the mucus plug. I know you guys are laughing at me who have had babies and know this. So apparently for you guys that don't have babies, let me scare the shit out of you. It's not scary at all. I don't know why I'm saying that. It's not freaky. I kind of think it's beautiful that your body does so many cool things to protect itself for the baby. We're gonna call this one cool, not gross. Like nipples getting the size of flying saucers. Me, I could do without it. Or I could keep it as long as it went back, but it's not going to. So we'll talk about that another time. Even though we just talked about it for 20 minutes. Your mucus plug is this. As soon as your body gets pregnant, it wants to protect that little baby that's growing inside of there. In order to protect it from things like bacteria or fungus or even sperm when you're having sex, like anything like that. And you guys that are medical or have kids and have more experience in this probably know better. So I think that's what it is. But your body forms this thick layer of mucus to cover your cervix so things can't go in. Bacteria, germs, sperm, all that stuff. It's called a mucus plug because literally it plugs it so nothing can go in. And I think that's also, this is TMI of all TMI, guys. Do I need to keep saying it? I think that's when the discharge comes worse, is after intercourse, because normally your body will absorb that sperm. If it doesn't make a baby that month, it'll still absorb it. That can't happen because the mucus plug is there blocking it, so it has to come out a different way. So sometimes a day or two after that is when you'll get the DCEs, the worst. Oh my God, I hope my family is not watching this video, like my aunts and uncles. Ugh. Please don't. Maybe I need a trigger warning disclaimer situation going on at the beginning of this. What happens when your body is preparing to give birth, your mucus plug eventually will fall out. It can fall out in a way that it comes out all at one time when you go to the bathroom, or like even not go to the bathroom, it'll just happen in your pants. But a lot of people say it happens when they go to the bathroom. And the only way to describe it is it looks like you have a really bad cold and you blew your nose on your toilet paper, but it's a ton apparently. But it also can also come out in drips and drabs. So it'll just be like a little mucusy over the course of, it could be a few days. Also, you cannot lose your mucus plug. Some people don't, or they don't before like their water breaks, and then maybe they do when they go into labor. I'm not sure how that works. I don't know how it works when you have a C-section. I don't wanna know. I do remember when my sister went into labor with her first, she called my mom and she said she lost her mucus plug, and like, I just didn't wanna know. And my mom's like, oh my God, I was so excited to be a grandmother. I swear you guys, my mom is punting babies from heaven. My best friend and I were joking that she's Oprah, like, you get a baby, you get a baby, you get a baby. Because three of us are pregnant at the exact same time. I'm due end of July, and two of my sisters are due 5 days apart early October. What? I'm just so sad that I'm not there to experience it with both of them. I feel like I would be like Brie and Nikki Bella, and I would want to do photo shoots together of our bellies and our babies. And okay, I'm gonna get sad. So I think that's everything on my list. I love you guys so much. Let me know what you think of this video. I'm sorry I'm lopsided. I hope I could fix it in editing. Whew. I don't even know what I did to get all this energy, but I am not complaining even a little bit. I love you guys. If you're not already subscribed, do it for the TMI. The girl talk. The coffee talk with Ro. The coffee talk with Ro. Okay, that's a little bit more of my accent. That's how I really stayed in my life. If you're interested in another video with me, click one of those that pops up on the screen. If you don't see that, just scroll back on my channel and watch whatever you want. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you in the next one. Mwah.